Good morning.
Morning. It's still quite early, just past six. We're on the way to the airport where I'm meeting up with terminal manager Marcus Ott. We'll take a look at what he's up to and whether I can give him a hand. Knock, knock. Morning. Good morning. Hi, I'm Volker. I'm Marcus. Hi. You know, Marcus, it was really hard for me to be here by 6:30. What's your work routine like?
You get used to it. You work 24/7, 365 days a year. Three shifts?
How many terminal managers are there?
Well, there are currently seven of us and one's always on duty.
Okay. Well, can I help you out today?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, great.
We'll start by checking the parking guidance system to see if it's working properly. We don't want to misdirect any customers.
When you're on a round like this, what do you watch out for?
Anything unusual. Oh, look, here's the first one, up here on P10. That display for the parking guidance system is out of order. Should show that P10 is closed.
Hannover Airport, good morning.
Hello,
Volker here. I want to report a minor display error.
Right.
We're at the entrance to P10. The display is not illuminated. It should say that P10 is closed, but it doesn't light up at all. Could you fix it?
One moment. Let me get into the system.
Yep.
Yeah, someone turned it off. I'll switch it back to closed.
Okay, thanks. Ah, it's working now. Thanks a lot.
Righto, okay, bye.
Well, my first assignment went well, but I can't imagine that's all a terminal manager has to do. What skills do you need? What competencies?
Well, to start with, you really have to know the airport. That's essential. You need airport experience. You need to know how it works. Just how did you gather all this experience over the years? Through my job at the airport service center. As a paramedic and on the security force. Thanks and bye. Look, I've got an appointment now, Volker.
Okay?
Can you take over for me? Right? What's up? A construction site in Terminal A, first door out front. Could you please check to see if everything is okay? Any obstacles around? Then go up to the boarding pass control. The scanner was down yesterday. See if everything is up and running again or not.
I'm on assignment in Terminal A. I'm off.
There's a construction site down here in the entrance area of Terminal A. A column is being refurbished. The entire area is roped off, and as far as I can see, thinking like a terminal manager now, focusing on passengers' welfare, they've done a good job of it. There's still enough room to get through with your luggage. I think this is a no-parking zone for construction vehicles. Looks good. I'll report that to Marcus.
Hello, good morning. I'm the terminal manager today. I'm to ask if your scanner is running properly. It seems to have been causing problems.
Unfortunately, it's still not working.
Okay, so we'll take care of it?
Okay, thanks.
Welcome. No, we're coming over. Bye.
That was Marcus. He's in the security area of Terminal A. We'll go over there now.
Okay, here's a story. Downstairs in Terminal A, on the departures level, the construction site is well secured. It looks good. The passengers still have enough room to get through with their bags. But upstairs, the lady at the boarding pass control said the scanner still isn't working properly.
Then we've got to take care of that.
Yes,
we have to call in a technician and see to the problem.
That means making phone calls and finding a solution.
Exactly.
Okay.
You keep hearing about it. Unsupervised luggage at an airport is quite a sensitive matter. That's part of your work too, isn't it?
We have an emergency scheme and a scenario for bringing in the task force. That includes the police, the terminal managers, the fire brigade, and ground services.
Almost 12 Marie, time for a break. Tie two?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, the terminal manager really is on the go a lot, taking care of everything for the benefit of the passengers, and I don't think they even realize it. I'll ask Marcus if he ever gets recognition for that. There's a lost and found here at the service center. Now we have a case where someone is picking up something for somebody else. The person who's come in has been authorized to do so. It's a laptop.
Yes, it's locked up in the strong room. We'll fetch it now. ...807. Here it is. Right, the laptop. 807.
We've got to hurry to Terminal A now. A suspicious object's been found there. We don't know what it is yet.
That was a real test performed by the authorities. They tested our inspection staff.
Right. Does that happen very often?
Yes, regularly actually.
We were just on the airport road in the terminal, and if I get it right, this here is the end of our assigned area, right?
Yes, the first thing the passengers see when they leave the airport is our service area.
Could you imagine working somewhere else?
Not really. It's a workplace with a special flair, where every day is different. Well, from the point of view of a terminal manager, in any case.
Our shift will be over soon. We've seen a lot. Do you ever get feedback?
Yes, we get personal and email feedback at the service center. But the best feedback we get is when everything is running smoothly.
I think we managed to achieve that today. Now the late shift will take over and I'll go back to my desk.